In this video, I'll show you how to design your talent job along with a custom solution for restart and recovery mechanism. Right, when you have hundreds of jobs and tables getting loaded in a one single workflow, and if that fails for whatever reason, and when you reprocess, it should be from the point of failure, not from the job one all over. Right, this will avoid all the data duplication, and also this is one of the best practices to implement in your real-time projects. So let's get started. So I'm on MySQL Workbench, and I'll be using ETL control table for this demonstration. So right now this table has got a job name, table name, and last success. Along with that we have a status flag, right? So let's make use of the status flag, which will determine which particular job has failed, right? You can also have a custom flags if you want to. Otherwise, you can just use status flag, right? So let's get into talent side. So I just have my job with a pre-job, right? This will actually create the connection. And for this demonstration, I'll just pull in the customer, and I'll pull in the stocks. I think only for these two jobs I have an entry here, stocks and customer. So I'll make use of these two jobs and show you the demo. So in order to make this work, we will have to first ensure that whenever a job is succeeded or failed, it has to go back to the database and make relevant updates, right? So I'm talking about this status field. So how do we update in case of any issues? So we have this feature, right? On sub job okay, on sub job error. So we will make use of that, and we will call one simple MySQL update command in a DB row component. So I have this DB row components already created, one for success and one for failure. Right, so if you look at the SQL in this DB row component, I am updating the ETL control table saying the status has succeeded for the particular job name. Right, for the customer job, this is the success, and for the failure one, we will set the status as failed. Right, so this is required for each and every job. So we will go ahead and connect it using success, which is on sub job OK. And in case of error, I want to call it as failed, right? We can similarly do it again for the remaining job as well. So in my case, I have stocks thing also, right? So let's go ahead and update the job name here. Okay, so I have updated the job name. So let's go ahead and connect it on sub job okay, on sub job error, right? So in order to perform the check, what we will do is we will have another DB row. Sorry, we will have another. So inside this DB input component, I'm trying to get the status from ETL control table where the job name is so and so, right? For the customer job, I'm using RBS underscore customer. So I'm pulling the status also. So if the status is succeeded, then only I'm getting this check performed. And we will make use of run if link, and we will connect it to RBS customer. So what will happen? So this query will be executed in the DB input component. It will pull out if the status is not equal to succeeded, which means it, either it's failed or it started its execution in the next day, right? This status needs to be reset every single day so that next day it becomes blank, and blank is not equal to succeeded. So this will be pulled from this DB input component. So using this runif command, we can trigger this particular job. So for this condition, what we will do is, since this is going to be a DB row DB input, I'll be getting the number of line. So what happens, I will make it as 1. So what happens if this particular job is not succeeded, then you will retrieve one particular record, right? So that's why we'll be making use of this condition, which says equal to one. So when this condition is satisfied, only this particular job will be getting triggered, right? So similarly, we'll make another copy of it, and we will connect it to using run if for the other job, right? So now we will change the job name here to stocks. Okay, and let's say if you have some hard dependency, you can still go ahead and do the on sub job okay and connect it to stocks, right? When you do such thing, you may have to add another run if so that the control is passed to this particular job when you don't have any hard dependencies, right? So for now, I'll just let it run in parallel. Now that the job is ready, so what we'll do is we'll go back to database and I'll manually set this to failed, right? So the status for the both the jobs is failed. So the expectation is with this condition, the control should be passed to the sub job and both should execute, and based on whatever execution status is, it will go back and update the database, right? So let's go ahead and run this job. Okay, so both the jobs are completed successfully. Let's see the link. Right, you see this condition as true, and it has also completed successfully, so it is marked as succeeded. Let's go back and verify. Okay, so both the jobs have succeeded. So now what I'll do is I will set one of the jobs to failed using job ID equals one. So I'll make this as failed and let's see what happens. So when we rerun our job, only the stocks job should run and this one should not run. So let's go back to Talend and run this particular job. Okay, now you see only the stock job has now executed with this true condition. The other customer job is not executed, right? And the stocks job has succeeded and it went back to the database and updated as status load. So let's check that again. Okay, see, the stocks job has succeeded successfully. So now I am going to do the same update again just to make this particular entry as failed. What now I will do is on talent job, I'll open up the stocks sub job. I'll make this purposefully failed by providing some wrong the input file, and also I'll make a check mark on the die on error. So let's go ahead and save it and I'll go back to the main job. So the status here is failed. So let's go ahead and run this particular job. Okay, so customer job has not executed because it's already succeeded. This particular sub job is now failed with the file not found exception because we purposefully made this in a wrong file name, right? And if you see, the error is now if you go back and check this, so the status is still failed, right? So let's say this will continue as long as we fix the issue, right? The cycle will continue and the status will be failed. And now let's go back and update this particular job with the proper file name. Right, now the job should succeed and update the status properly. Right, now the job has succeeded fine. And let's check this GTL control, both are succeed. And even if you rerun the job, nothing should be working. See, both are false. So this is how you will implement the custom restartability based on your ETL control job status.